I haven't posted for a while because I've been doing the same job. Not only boring for me, but boring for you to watch. But today we've got a new job come in and we're collecting from a small place at the top of Anglesey in North Wales, lobsters to go to the fish market in Boulogne. I hope you enjoy. Done this job before, but I have been warned that the roads get a bit tight. Seems okay at the moment, so we'll go along and see what happens. I've got to turn right up here by this garage somewhere, so I think that's where the fun starts. Too bad at the moment. Very pretty, typical Wales, strange words on the floor, but yeah, just typical country roads. We'll just go along and see how we get.
With a whistle, man, it's hotter than a $2 pistol, baby. I know
come in. Thank you. Thank you. Very nice man. Thank you.
It's a night alone neath the desert stars. It's the 5 o'clock whistle, it's the classroom bell. It's a Panama City out the window, yeah. The first kiss after a broken heart. We all wanna break the chains. Feel the wind against our face. Everybody wants the same. It's telling that boss he can kiss your ass. That ticket to your favorite show. Getting lost in the rock and roll. Close your eyes, hands up high. Go on and let it all go. We all wanna break the chains. Feel the wind against our face. Everybody wants the same.
Apparently, round here, it gets a disaster in the summer with tourists, and they've put these posts here to stop them parking on that in front of their house, which is understandable. So going around here, there's a very, very nice man that works at this place. He has lorries of his own, and he's warned me about this bit. The problem being is that if I get too close to that wall on the left, then it's going to take the front corner out, but you can't actually get straight, or you've got to wind it around, a bit like going around spoons. So it's the bush that's on the right hand side that really you need to watch, because you're not sure if you're pushing past the bush or you're catching the wall. But if you just take it really, really slow and it goes. I see this is the hairpin bend that the very nice man warned me about as well. He said take it very, very wide. I can't show you because I need to concentrate. Going round. Nope. She's not wide enough. Let's go back again. Let's go back and have another swing at it. You can see where somebody there has caught the wall, the embankment. Let's just go back and get another swing at it. He did say just take it really wide and get your trailer behind you, which almost, but not quite. Let's go back and get a, as I have the brand new trailer on, I don't want to stove my side locker in. Let's just go back a bit and see if we can get another bite at it. Right, bigger swing, biggest wing. I bet that car's behind are wondering what I'm doing. Biggest wing at it. Take it round. Let's see. Should go round. At least I'm going the right way because there's a little sign there, look. Let's just take it steady. It's alright, they've cut the embankment right back, so at least you can see the embankment. Steady way. I'll try and show you how tight it was. You've got an inch maybe by that wall, but I need to concentrate. The last thing I need is to scratch a new trailer. Just take it steady. I think once around it'll be, it looks like a straight enough road. Yep. Turn it easy, does it? The worst thing is, well, I don't want to scratch the front because that is right by where that other driver has caught the embankment is the same place that I would catch it if I'm not careful. And then it's just one of those things, you just have to take it steady. Next time, at least I'll know to take it massive swing round to get in. That's it, we're through, we're around, off we go. I'll try and take a picture of that wall on the way out so you can see just exactly what I mean. Definitely a hairpin bend, but that's it, we're through. And then apparently it's along here, follow this road a bit more and it have to turn down to the left. But I can see the sea. I love the seaside, which I'm told is not the seaside, it's the beach. Politically correct, but to me it's a seaside. I've got to turn left somewhere along here. I hope I haven't passed it. I haven't seen any more signs yet. And the sat nav is telling me to go straight on. Not always the case, but there's nowhere else to go at the moment, so we just have to keep going anyway. This is the thing, actually, when you're going along these places and you're not sure whether you've gone past it or not, you're constantly looking up road ends and in gateways to think, yeah, it's okay, I could turn around there, I'll reverse it back up here, I could turn it in there, just in case. You're conscious, it's in the back of your mind, oh yeah, I could get round that one. So I don't think it's going to be a case, everything says carry on, but you are aware in your head, a bit like that lay-by there, just think, yeah, I can. That's all right, I can turn it there. Have a sign. This is where we're going, turning left here. That's a relief. It's getting a bit tight. I did look at it on Google Maps, so it kind of gave me an idea of the layout before I came up. And so I knew this turning should be okay, so it should be down here on the right. Hot seaside. It's a bit breezy though. I do love the seaside. Let's see what we can find down here. Yay! There we are. That's where we're going. On the right-hand side there. So, let's see if we can get it in. Apparently, all around here, the guy was telling me, it's absolutely jammed with tourists in the summer. All down that road, they're parked everywhere. And he said, any problems, he said, just park in the road and walk away. He said, we put signs out. He said, do not park. Lorries constantly moving. We put cones out and they move the cone so they're on the outside of the cars. It's like we put the cones there for some reason, so you don't park there. He said we've had the police down. He said it's an absolute nightmare in the summer. He said just think yourself lucky that you come in the winter. So I've got to get up there, mm-hmm. And that little blue car is on the left hand side of me, so I'll have to watch the tail swing. Need to concentrate a bit. We'll get up there. So I didn't manage to record going in. The lady came out and she helped me watch the tail swing going round. Bit tight, but we got in there. Really, really, really nice people. Well, good morning. Parked in their yard last night. It absolutely bucketed it down with rain to the point where I had to make my tea in the back of the trailer. So I've been for a walk this morning. I've just insert my touristy pictures and video. It's very, very pretty. It's a dead end and you can walk all up the coast. Very touristy, as I said yesterday, but very pretty area. So I'm just sat in the lorry and this bloke's come in front. That thing's like a big kettle, big thing of boiling water. He's filled it with water and now he's putting lobster in it. Turns out, when I spoke to him, they weren't in there long at all. So it turns out when I spoke to him that he does it for like people come and they buy sacks, they put them in. They're cooked now, the lobster are now cooked, or part cooked, and he puts them in sacks and they sell it to people that come up and say we want to buy some lobster. And he does this every day, or near enough every day. And you can see they're coming out pink. They were in black and they're coming out pink. But this guy's been doing this for ever and ever, apparently. And there you go, bags of fresh lobster. I've nearly finished packing. Then that'll go on the back of the trailer. It's not a lot. It's quality, not quantity, apparently, at this place. And we're loaded, so we just need to get out of here. Just fiddle about to try and get straight where we fiddled to get in. Now there is a guy behind me just showing me back through the narrow bit. There is a space behind for me to reverse into, so that reverse into it through the narrow bit and then just go turn right towards the exit of the yard. Now, talking to the guy that drives the lorries that gave me the advice coming in, he said it's easier to actually reverse off the road into the space that I'm reversing into. So do a U-ey off the road, round to the right, and then you're going straight back through the narrow bit. So you'd actually be reversing into the turning bit. Makes sense to me when he said it. He said, I've been doing it for years, and over the years, that's the easiest way I've found. I mean, it is really tight. These two walls come right up by the side of the trailer, and the roof hangs out a bit. And there's a hole down on my right here. So just a drainage hole, which again makes it a bit tight. Helpful man, a bit of local knowledge always helps, eh? See why they were saying about the tourists, if they're all parked along here, it would make it tight. You can imagine it, but we'll cross that bridge in the summer, I think. next time. Oh, did I mention I live the seaside? Nice view. See, it doesn't look as tight going this way. If I show you, try and bring you around here a bit. So you can see it's actually a hairpin bend. So I'll go right up here. It's not as tight coming out as it is going in. I can tell that straight away. But I do want to go down there. See, so, yeah. And it's not as tight coming out as going in, but we just need to keep it tight to the right here, keep it on this wall. You can see the bush now, you can see the bush where I was trying to explain earlier, but I've put little pictures. That little bush on the left, look, you're not actually on the wall, but it's difficult to tell whether the wall is in that bush first time through. And we'll just take it steady. The wall comes up really tight, hang on, let me see. There you go, that's where we are with the wall. And the bush that side. We'll just oh, that'll slow you down a bit, mate. Well done. You have to go back a bit. It's just big lorry, big white lorry coming through. You're gonna have to move. Just go down that entrance. Go down there. Thank you. Well done, that man. Still not a lot of room, but we don't want to knock the ice down either. There we are. Through. Let's have a look. Yeah. It's a very pretty wall. We don't want to knock it over. More importantly, we don't want to scratch a new trailer. We're away. Thank you very much. Interesting place to stop and decide to have a bit of a chat with your neighbour. Park 2 foot away from the curb. Oh, it's okay, she's going to move it. Just it's a village life, I guess. We're just stop here and have a bit of a chat. I would try and squeeze by, but there's not a lot of room for me to squeeze into. Oh, and we've forgotten something, very important piece of information. Interesting. So we just got to get back out onto the main A55. So just go along this road a bit till we get to them, get to that garage, and then turn left, and then back out to the dual carriageway again. So it's not too bad. I'm not taking this to Boulogne. Somebody else has taken it, so I'm going to go down and swap trailers with him. So I just hope he looks after my new trailer. Doing the hard work again around the tight bends. I hope you enjoyed this one. I'll try and do some more when something a bit more, some of the interesting stuff comes up. And I'll catch up with you soon. Take care. So this is the bit by the garage where we want to turn left, turned right coming in. So as you can see, Mr. Bright Spark is coming up the inside of me. I'm in this lane with my left hand indicator on because I've got to take up all the room to get round the, and don't take the cars out going the other way. And he's slowly creeping up on the inside. Bright Spark. So I have to take up all the room to get round, and he's still coming. What a dick.